Sloan's Journal, Spring 2017. A student has stolen several of our beloved teachers from us. Without their guidance and structure, the children have betrayed each other. The school has changed. Wilton's math ties, Jeremy Lloyd's sweet, central voice, all gone. Math I used to mean something, a badge of honor, a token of integrity. Now, nothing but desolate, overflowing gutter of filth and lies. GPAs are down, morale is in the toilet, parents are complaining. The school is afraid of me. I've seen its true face. Now the whole program stands on the brink, staring down into fragmentation. On Friday night, an econ teacher was stolen from his classroom. Somebody knows why. Out there, somebody knows why. The dusk reeks of deceit and bad consciences. Something must be.
Epidemic wiping out teachers. And I've come to you, Misfits, to solve this problem.
Thank you, sir, for giving us the opportunity to show our detective prowess.
Yeah, well, literally anything is better than this calc test I'm missing right now.
Hey, sorry I'm late. I had to drive all around town to find this outfit.
All right, whatever. I have a situation for you all to handle. Teachers are dropping like a third-term GPA. I need you all to find who's kidnapping these teachers and bring them to justice. We gotta figure out what's happening because the whole school is in chaos. Our intel team tells us that a student is responsible for the disappearance of these teachers. But we haven't heard from them since they've entered the cafeteria sector.
Burns! Burns!
We've lost contact.
so cold.
Oh, one more thing. I'd like for you to meet Thomas.
Hey, everybody.
Now, he's a rookie around here, so I'd like you guys to show him the ropes.
Are you kidding me? This is ridiculous.
We can't have some Boy Scout screwing up our investigation. This is serious.
Actually, Mr. Johnson, sir, I'm actually an Eagle Scout. Sir, common misconception.
Great, great. No, this is great. I love babysitting.
Just deal with it. What are you waiting for, Miss Harvey, to have another baby? You've got justice to serve.
Yes, sir.
Why don't we go see Miss Klein first? Otherwise, we'll never find a way to incorporate freshmen in this movie.
Miss Klein, how are you doing?
Hi.
Welcome. Hello, sweeties. How are y'all today?
We hate to interrupt, but we have a few questions about your missing colleagues.
I would love to help, but unfortunately, I'm in the middle of my Lord of the Flies unit, and you boys know how much I love Lord of the Flies. Why don't you try Mr. Fouts' room? I think the math sci files are in his cabinet.
Cabinet in Mr. Fouts' room. Got it.
Oh, Miss Klein, we all know how much you'd love teaching this unit.
We're not going to take up any more of your valuable time.
Aw, you boys are welcome back anytime.
Bye, Miss Klein.
Wait! Don't forget to take a lolly with you.
Thanks, Miss Klein.
Goodbye.
Wait up, guys. I think I left my gov textbook in there.
Gov textbook? Doesn't Ben Smith go to Virginia Tech?
Yes, my children.
Where's your textbook?
Yeah, what took you so long?
Yeah, I don't want to talk about it.
You can use mine if you want.
I'm okay, thank you.
So, let's go get those files out of Mr. Fouts' room.
Yeah, let's just try to stay focused. Otherwise, we'll have to finish this investigation at Cab Morning, like all our other work.
I agree. Let's just try to stay on task, everyone.
Philip-san, we're gonna be late for anime club.
Come on, team. Let's try and get those files. Where is Mr. Fouts' room again? 429, right?
No. Remember, he doesn't teach math sci anymore.
Wait. So that means he's in the 300 hallway.
No! No! Come on, guys. We're math sci kids. We can do anything. Hey, Tostito. Guess what?
Actually, sir, my name's Thomas.
Guys,
hey, what are you guys doing?
Guys, I can't breathe.
Hey, where did you get that pocket sand?
Don't worry about it.
To the 300 hallway!
Yeah!
Alright, we're here, Dingleberries.
I hope Mr. Fowl isn't here. His beard terrifies me.
Who's Mr. Fowl?
Shut up, Timmy.
Yeah, we had Fowl back in the good old days when you were still a prepubescent mongrel.
I'll never forget that one map of Europe we had to do in freshman year.
Now, William, about this map. This has got to be one of the worst pieces of garbage I've ever seen. And I truly mean that from the bottom of my heart.
Good times.
Hold on, hold on.
What is it?
The chess club normally uses this room for tournaments.
So? All we have to do is get in and get the files.
Yeah, it should be fine, right?
No. Have you ever seen the chess club?
Wow, I haven't seen that much excitement since my last English seminar.
Furthermore, using the psychoanalytical lens, Freud proves Golding's assumption regarding the savagery of humanity true, further establishing the archetypal literary legitimacy of modernist British 20th century realism. So, does anyone have any comments?
Well, how do we get the records now? Those kids are crazy.
Yeah, we need a way to calm them down or something.
What's that sound?
Yeah, she's practically unconscious.
Well, what was she working on?
Ugh, gross. Do you guys remember intermolecular forces in sophomore year?
Yes, actually.
Chemistry? Definitely not.
I was always asleep.
All right, I think we know what to do.
Let's head to the lab.
So we have to use chemistry to try and get those chess kids to fall asleep?
Miss Klein has class all day, so she's busy.
What about Dr. Lloyd?
Dr. Lloyd left last year though, didn't he?
Do you have to be so negative, Toby?
Once again, it's actually Thomas.
Whatever, Frank.
We could try calling Dr. Lloyd?
Well, do you see anyone around here with Dr. Lloyd's contact information laying around?
Yeah, well...
Where did you get...
Shh.
how did you even...
Shh.
So why would you...
What are you doing?
What is love? What is life?
Well, now we have his phone number, I guess.
Love. Lloyd is life. Lloyd is love. Lloyd is life.
Lloyd is love. Lloyd is life. Lloyd is love. Lloyd is life. Lloyd is love. Lloyd is life. Lloyd is love. Lloyd is life. Lloyd is love. Lloyd is life. Lloyd is love. Lloyd is life. Lloyd is love.
Lloyd is love. Lloyd is life. Lloyd is love. Lloyd is life. Lloyd is love. Lloyd is life.
Now that we have his number, let's call him, I guess.
Give me his number.
Hello.
Hey, Dr. Lloyd, how's it going?
Oh, hello there, Max. I'm happy you asked. My wife and I finally just...
Yeah, that's great. So I've got an AP test coming up, and I was wondering if you could help explain dipole-dipole interactions?
Well, anything for my favorite students. Dipole-dipole forces are attracted between the positive end of one polar molecule and the negative end of another polar molecule. And that's dipole-dipole interactions.
Oh, yeah, thanks, Dr. Lloyd.
Red but marked.
All right, let's get to work.
Okay, is everybody ready to unleash the Lloydinator 3000?
Max, is that a wedding ring?
All right, let's unveil the final product.
Ready.
Dipole forces have strengths that range from 5 kilojoules to 20 kilojoules per mole.
This will help us find our suspect, guys.
Hey, aren't we missing someone?
Philip! Philip, oh my God, Philip. Oh. Why?
What happened? I thought his headphones were in.
It looks like they've been disconnected.
There's nothing we can do for him. He's in Lloyd limbo now.
Okay, let's take a look at those records.
What is this?
It's just a bunch of grades.
But what does it mean?
I don't know, it's just too dense. I can't figure it out.
Well, who do we know who's really good at simplifying and clarifying dense information in a comprehensible and understandable way?
Hey, what about Dr. E?
Well, he hasn't really been the same since his surgery.
People say he's been darker.
Hey, Dr. E, can you help me with number 3 on the worksheet?
Yo, take it easy, Gilbert. I got 100 on the last test. I got this one. Watch and learn, cheese balls. So if you take the double integral of the sine of omega of...
Yeah, I wouldn't ask him for help.
What is this?
I don't know, Thomas. Probably your parents' divorce papers.
Well, whenever I don't understand something, I ask Miss Solden.
Sophomores.
Actually, he has a point. Maybe she can help.
This is everything we know so far about this investigation. Let's show these notes and report card to Miss Solden for some fresh eyes.
You've been taking notes? Such an infant, I swear.
All right, let's see what we're working with here. Okay, what exactly am I looking at?
Next page.
Hold on, let me sign that with integrity real quick.
Hold up. Let me edit this. I'm not trying to lose any points in spelling errors.
You're such an elitist. All right, we're kind of on a time crunch here. Hey, Miss Solden, what's up?
Oh, hey guys.
We've got this report card, but we can't figure out why it's important. Could you look at it for us?
Sure. Oh, this is easy, guys. You're not looking at it from the right perspective. Sure, this is a great report card, but for a math sci kid, A-. Might as well be an F. You need to change your perspective.
Wait, Joey, you forgot to write with integrity on this.
Wait, what do you mean? I wrote it right there.
We're gonna make this bird sing.
Diana Blavica, try it now!
Choose a target! You will fight with that integrity for the last time!
No, wait, no!
Off to the Honor Council with you.
His future is ruined!
No! No!
That didn't go very well.
We should go ask Mrs. Curran for help.
Well, her room is right over there.
Hey, Miss Curran.
No!
Thanks, bro.
You okay, bro?
Yeah, bro. I don't know what I would have done if you weren't here, bro.
I'll always have your back, bro.
Hey! Can you hoodlums keep it down? I'm trying to enter grades so you don't make fun of me in the movie this year.
I'm sorry, Miss Clopton. We'll be more careful next time.
I'm always watching, William. Always watching.
Oh yeah, by the way, guys, I forgot to mention, Karen likes to throw shoes.
I guess you could say she's totally crazy. Almost as if she's trying to shoo us away. What's that sound?
I think that's the new bell Dr. Marks got in Japan. I think it's supposed to be more soothing or something.
Sure hope we don't have a tardy
sweep. This is a tardy sweep. Teachers, if you would, close your doors at this time. Students that are in the hallway.
Wait for him.
Options here, William. The team is falling apart. We have no leads. And Justin Sweat took my calculator again. That's it. It's every man for himself. We gotta fix this while we can before we all get put in ISD.
Hold on, Mr. Johnson. Don't give up hope yet. What if we tried this?
What are you doing? We can cross-check the grade records of Synergy. Then use that analysis to find students who got similar grade deductions from all the teachers.
Mr. Johnson, I figured it out.
There's nowhere else to run, William. Let's talk about this.
Enough talking. This has gone on long enough.
I don't understand. When Mr. Burns, he said a student was responsible for the disappearances. He was talking about you.
All the years of hard work and dedication, what do I have to show for it? A minuses. Nothing but A minuses. How am I supposed to get into Yale with A minuses? Something had to be done. The only way to make up for those abysmal grades was to take 8 AP classes this year. My weighted GPA, it would be unparalleled. The counselors, they said it couldn't be done. They said I'd lose my mind balancing all the extracurriculars and the rigorous workload. So I utilized the resources available to me.
Yes, I'll be there soon. Yes. Is this Miss Amato again?
AP Stat, AP Gov, AP Calc, AP Psych, AP Physics. I forced the teachers to do my work for me.
Carry the two.
And then, of course, I had to deal with this pesky investigation.
Hold up, Joseph. Let me peer at it, that. Not trying to get points off for spelling errors.
Easy enough, really. All it took was some planning and execution.
How could you betray us like that? I trusted you, William. We all did.
Trust is a chemical defect of the losing side.
You think you're smarter than all of us, but you must be pretty dumb to betray your friends like that.
What did you call me?
You heard me, William. You're a big dummy.
You're gonna regret that. I have the high ground.
I will do what I must.
Jack, help me!
Like a tea, like a tsunami? Tetanus. Tetanus! Tetanus, no! Tetanus! Tetanus!
Jack, I knew you'd save me.
Right on schedule, actually. And now, to deal with the final piece of evidence. And now, Jack, you're going to write a confession of how you kidnapped all the teachers to do your work for you.
William, how could you do this to your friends?
Friends don't get degrees, Jack. Now hurry up. Your precious protege gets it.
The Honor Council will bring you to justice. Trent!
I am the Honor Council!
Don't do it, Mr. Johnson!
Just take it.
Now give Tadpole back!
All my loose ends, finally tied up. Except for one.
What are you saying, William?
Jack, he knows too much.
It's okay, Mr. Johnson. Thanks for letting me tag along. Mom always used to worry I wouldn't make any friends here.
Thomas,
it's nothing personal.
Why didn't I see you for who you were?
Because you're an idiot. No, Jack, don't be like that. Almost everyone is. I'll be turning you into Burns now.
Thank goodness you're here. I've got it, the answer to everything.
What is it?
He confessed and everything.
What?
Yeah, didn't believe it, but it was him the whole time.
Okay, all right. Thank you.
Of course.
Come on, guys. Mad sidekicks. We can do anything.
Dear Mr. Folds, on behalf of Yale University, I am delighted to congratulate you on your acceptance into our 2017 program. As you know, Yale University has a rich history of academic excellence, and we review the many hundreds of applications we receive.
Johnson. Mail.
Mr. Johnson, I hope you never have to read this letter. I'm scared, Mr. Johnson. I don't know what to do. I feel like I know about the identity of our culprit, but I'm too afraid to question him. I'm writing this to be delivered just in case something happens. I sent my notebook to Mr. Burns with all the evidence. I guess taking notes pays off sometimes. Anyway, I'm hoping Mr. Burns will connect the dots. I'm sorry I wasn't brave enough to stop all this when I had the chance. And Mr. Johnson, I want you to know that despite all the name-calling, it felt nice to be a part of something. You guys are like the big brothers I never had. I can't thank you enough for everything. With integrity, Dennis.
You wanted to see me, Sloan? Don't worry, he'll have time to congratulate me at graduation.
Of course, Mr. Folds. Actually, I wanted to ask you some questions.
Sorry, what is this? I'm a little distracted. I'm just, you know, writing my graduation speech.
Oh, I don't think you're gonna have to worry about that anymore.
What is the meaning of this? What is this? What? No! 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 It's a mistake!
Yes, I suppose I did make a mistake. Fortunately, someone else had my back.
No! 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 No!
Wait! Let me talk to him.
How could you outsmart me? My plan was foolproof.
I just put my faith in the honor code, and it came through.
But it's just a piece of writing. It doesn't mean anything.
That's where you're wrong, William. That's where we're all wrong. To be in the math and science program, it's not about a GPA boost or a college app. It's about passion. It's about friendship. It's about transition into adulthood. It's about overcoming obstacles, striving to improve. It's about proving yourself despite all the odds. It's about making memories with the ones you love. It's about being a part of something
It's about acceptance. It's about making your dad proud. It's about family and love and union and community and camaraderie and honesty and integrity. And I wish I could go back to that scared little kid taking the math science entrance exam and just tell him that it was all gonna be okay. That he'd have something to look back on. That he'd be welcomed and loved and nurtured and guided through the terrifying emotional conundrum that is the indescribable uncertainty of adolescence. I want him to know that there's nothing to be afraid of. That's what Matt Sy's about.